Meanwhile, authorities warn netizens about unscrupulous individuals using Facebook for prostitution. The details in this report.
Many youths are spending more time on social networking sites such as Facebook, but authorities warn the site is also being used for prostitution. Facebook user Joshua says he logs into Facebook to keep in touch with his friends.
Yung mga friends ko, like their statuses.
His mother, meantime, admits she does not monitor her son's online activities. She was surprised when she was informed about prostitution in the social networking site.
Oh my God! Kasi hindi mo naman makakontrol yan eh.
A Facebook group called Under One Roof features female members who engage in prostitution. They post their pictures and contact numbers in the group, which serves as a venue where they can get customers. But the National Bureau of Investigation warns those who are involved in the group are violating Republic Act 9208 or the Anti-Trafficking Persons Act. The operator of the group could face a 15-year jail term. The NBI says the cybercrime law could hasten its investigation into the group as it could help them locate the IP address of the suspect. But the Supreme Court has issued a temporary restraining order against the controversial law.
Let's talk to the NBI's head agent and chief technical intelligence division, Palmer Malyari. He's on the line now. Good afternoon, Agent Malyari.
Good afternoon, TJ.
All right.
Tell the viewers.
Can you give us more clarification on how this works, how this prostitution via Facebook works, and can they be held liable?
Okay, TJ, actually, this type of modus operandi has been operating for several years already. Mm-hmm. It just happened that in a very recent case which was referred to us by ABS-CBN, particularly in Stinkweb, it appears that Facebook now is being used by some members in order to get customers in some kind of prostitution ring.
Mm-hmm. All right, and with this, what laws can they be violating? There's, of course, the anti-trafficking law. Will they also be liable for the anti-cybercrime law?
Okay, that's a very good question, actually. We are actually looking at a possible violation of Republic Act 9208, which is the Anti-Trafficking in Persons Act, particularly Section 5C. If you would bother to check the provisions of Section 5C, which is acts that promote trafficking in persons, it is very clear in that provision of the law that any act of advertising, publishing, printing, broadcasting, or distributing any advertisement which would promote trafficking in persons by the use of information technology and the internet is actually a violation of the said law. So mm-hmm. It's very clear that the internet now, the Facebook, is being used to invite customers to engage in prostitution. And it's very clear that it's the applicable law.
All right. And would there be any liability for others who, like, for example, parents or, you know, even just concerned people who want to look at it if they just like or join the group just to check what's inside?
Well, not necessarily liking or visiting the site.
Mm-hmm.
What the NBI actually looks at is for the people engaged in the, you know, in the act of maintaining the website and, mm-hmm. and the women who offer themselves to prospective customers. Mm-hmm. Other than that, if you bother to check Republic Act 9208, there is a clear provision there which states that any person who would engage or buy services of trafficked persons, particularly those engaged in prostitution, are also liable under the said law.
Mm-hmm.
For a first time offender, one could be held liable for payment of a fine, mm-hmm. I think of 50,000 pesos, other than rendering community service for 6 months. If you're a second and subsequent offender, the imprisonment would be 1 year plus a fine of 100,000 pesos. But the act of liking or visiting the website mm-hmm. is not necessarily something which the NBI would look at.
All right, but you did mention that those will be held liable for those who maintain the site. But technically speaking, this site is maintained by Facebook. So are you going to be holding them liable as well?
Not only Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
The ones who actually went on to register the account with Facebook.
Okay, the admins of the group, basically.
Yes. In fact, the reason mm-hmm. why we coordinated with Facebook is for us to be able to get the IP address
mm-hmm.
pertaining to the creation of the account mm-hmm. and all subsequent accesses into the account. So We're looking at the ones who actually created it and maintaining it right now.
Mm-hmm. And are they being cooperative, talking about Facebook with regards to your investigation?
Well, in the past, we would not say that there is 100% cooperation, mm-hmm. because in the first place, there is no law that would compel the people from Facebook, right. to give information to the NBI, the mm-hmm. BNP. But we have had good experiences as well from Facebook, in the sense that mm-hmm. in some instances, they would forward to us information that would be very vital in identifying the subject of the case.
Okay. But with regards to locating the users, the owners, for sure they're not using their real names or their real group names. If you don't have the help of Facebook, can you just get their IP addresses somehow?
Yeah, we expect that. The moment the IP address is given by Facebook,
okay.
you would be able to know already the internet service provider which was used to access the internet and eventually mm-hmm. perform the act. And
right.
at the moment we send a subpoena to the ISP, mm-hmm. the ISP may be able to give us the information to mm-hmm. the subscriber which maintains the internet account. Now,
right.
the only problem is that before, we have difficulty getting information from the ISPs because mm-hmm. there is no law that would compel them to share information with
right.
law enforcement. But since the passage of the law, which is Cybercrime Prevention Act,
mm-hmm.
there is now a remedy available to law enforcement for us to be able to apply for a court warrant, just so that the court will be the one to issue the order to require the ISPs to produce the needed information.
Mm-hmm.
But the problem right now is, because of the suspension through a TRO, we cannot make use of that remedy right now.
All right. And so with the TRO, you cannot at all use any of the provisions of that law, in particular with this case?
Yes, TJ. Yes, TJ.
All right. What's your appeal to the public? I mean, how can parents be more vigilant? How can, the youth out there be more wary of these scenarios and these modus operandi as you're talking about?
Well, for parents who have minor children, I would suggest that they should be vigilant in explaining to their children the ethics and the use of the internet. If it's possible, they would be able to monitor the use of the computer and the internet, if the computer can be situated in a place where it's easily seen by the parents,
mm-hmm.
so that they would be able to see what kinds of websites are being visited by their children. That
mm-hmm.
That would be a good proposal.
All right, that's a good point right there. Thank you for joining us and giving us clarification.
Thank you.
Head Agent and Chief Technical Intelligence Division of the NBI, Agent Palmer Magliari. Thank you.
In other news,